As I said at the top of the show, average principal pay in North Carolina had dropped to an embarrassing 50th nationally a year ago. The General Assembly responded, but not everyone believes we're on the right track. So joining us first to talk about it is Dr. Stephen Gainey. Dr. Gainey is the superintendent of Randolph County School System. Dr. Gainey, thanks for being here.
Thank you for having me.
You've got 31 schools in Randolph County, so you've got 31 principals you've got to hire, retain, keep, support. The changes that were made to the principal pay plan last year, and I mean, we've talked about it on the show before, but really the biggest changes were they took away, experience doesn't factor into it now. It doesn't factor into advanced degrees, and really tied it to test score growth in a lot of ways, growth in academic performance over time. What are your thoughts about just that approach?
Well, I want to start by saying I appreciate that we're having this conversation. As I told my principals in the past 12, 15 months, I'm excited that this is a topic we're discussing because I think there's just tremendous value on having great principals leading schools. I have several concerns. I have concerns about when you start having a salary schedule where a principal's salary can go up or down from year to year, what are you going to accomplish in the schools over long haul? Because I talked to our principals a lot about building positive school cultures, and you can't build those overnight. And so if a school's academic growth goes up and you don't have a positive school culture to go with it that takes multiple years to build, there's a chance it can go right back, or it can fall right back.
Right.
So very concerned about the volatility of the salary schedule. But I want to go back to my first statement. I appreciate that this conversation is such a hot conversation in North Carolina because we need to be having this conversation about leaders of schools.
Well, and let's talk about that. You mentioned culture. I mean, when you're looking for a new principal or potentially elevating someone, is that when you look at them, are you looking at someone who you think can drive a culture or maintain? Is that a big part of it? Because I know having a daughter in schools myself, you could tell. I mean, a school really had a culture. Was it a place where learning happened, where teachers felt supported and they worked with each other, or not, right?
Well, I think it all works together. And that's why I've been doing this 25 years now, and I've watched schools, if they don't have that positive culture, then the academic improvement that might take place does not continue on over years. So when I'm talking to principals or principal candidates, I'm looking for that principal who, A, is comfortable with who they are, and I feel like can build relationships with the staff and the students and the parents and the community, because that is as important as the academic growth, because quite frankly, that's going to be one of the big factors to sustain the academic growth, and you can't build that in 1 year.
Right. Under the new principal pay plan that was passed last year, it's estimated about 1 in 5 principals in North Carolina will actually lose pay, not just not get a raise, but actually see a cut in pay later this year unless something has changed. Are you concerned about losing veteran principals because of that?
Very concerned. And you know, I've worked in 3 school systems in the state, and I love Randolph County School System. It's the best job I've had. I love the people in Randolph County School System, but I also love the state of North Carolina. I'm a product of the public schools in North Carolina, and I don't want to see us lose principals in Randolph County School System. I also don't want to see the state of North Carolina lose principals. And I worry that with this volatility up and down of this salary schedule, are we going to put principals in a position that they may be thinking, well, I have enough years to retire. I really wanted to go on further. I still love what I'm doing, but maybe I need to go ahead and step out. And that could be a big blow to the state of North Carolina. It could be a big blow to the Randolph County school system.
And not all of our viewers know this, but you can quickly explain on the pension. You were a principal, you're a superintendent. So when you retire, I mean, say you get your 25, 30 years in, what is your pension based on?
The highest 4 consecutive school
highest
years.
Highest 4 consecutive. So if it goes down in those last few years, it could have an impact.
It could affect
going forward.
It could affect what window of service you're looking at.
Right. So how do you evaluate a principal, and what do you think if you were, if you could just design something, how would you want to sort of compensate a principal?
Well, academic performance has to be there, so there's no question that piece needs to stay. If we could do a compensation schedule, I would like to see something there with years of service, additional degrees, the advanced degrees. I think that needs to be there because there is tremendous learning when principals are pursuing advanced degrees, when teachers are pursuing advanced degrees. There is tremendous learning. That is, they're learning, and that does come back and impact schools in a positive way. And so I'd like to see those two factors return. I also like the, there's things about the salary schedule I like. I like that we're talking about school size. I like that. And I would like that to be factored in. I have a concern that the current schedule.
Yeah, we mentioned, you mentioned, tell me about that, the idea of what size school it is.
Well, most of my schools, my high schools are, we have one 3A and the other ones are 2A, and then we have early college for 400 students. So we don't have the high schools that are just the huge ones, but I was the principal of a high school that went from 25 to 2,600 students the 5 years, 4.5 years I was there as principal. And you know, that's a big difference when the salary schedule cuts off at 1,300.
Right.
So I think there needs to be some recognition for some other size schools.
Right. So one of the things, there is a new bill that was introduced last week, Senate Bill 718. We don't know if that's going to pass or not, but it does extend the hold harmless provision, basically that no principal will lose pay this upcoming school year. And then there's another provision in it that would extend if a high-performing principal goes to a challenging school environment, low-performing school, there's a 3-year hold harmless. I guess, what are your thoughts? Do you think is that enough?
Well, I like the idea of protecting the principal who you may ask to go to another school and try to get it moving. I like that idea, and I appreciate that. And I talked with Mr. Tillman. I know he put forth that bill, and he's one of our legislators, and always very easy for me to talk to. But I'm very concerned about the piece of, we had held harmless for 17-18, principals couldn't make less than they were making in 16-17. So I'm a little concerned about why now it's fine for, I'm concerned about them possibly making less than 18-19 compared to 17-18. Right. And we have a precedent for that when we did the ABC program. And there was, principals earned bonuses and they stayed in their salary and moved with them. So that concerns me, it does.
Well, there'll be some more work done on for sure. We're gonna talk to two principals next and get their take on it. But Dr. Gainey, I appreciate you coming in and talking to us.
Thank you.
So when we come back, you're gonna hear from two award-winning principals